Good morning, everybody. It's a pleasure to be here. I've heard so much about SIT in Schaffhausen, and eventually, now today and tomorrow, I'm here to see and experience the place. When I was asked to give a talk at the beginning of the meeting, I said, I'm not really good in making, you know, big general statements about politics and strategy. I usually share my personal experience, because so often when we make generalizations and have these big general statements, they're really anchored down in something which either we or people around us have experienced. And for me, it has been a formative experience in my career, the tension between fundamental and applied research. I was drawn to fundamental research. I worked as an undergraduate student and in my master thesis on theoretical physics. On the other hand, as a young person being aware about the problems of the world, I also wanted to directly contribute to the solution of the problems of the world. And eventually, after my master thesis in theory, I said, no, I have to do applied research. Applied research is what society needs. And so eventually I took my knowledge in atomic and molecular physics and applied it to the research of flames, laser diagnostics of flames or laser diagnostics of in a running diesel engine. So I did applied research, and I can tell you, as a researcher, when you work with laser light for clean environment, you can talk to your friends, you can talk to your parents, everybody knows what you're doing, you're doing great things. On the other hand, while I did this work, I realized personally I was missing something. I'm a person who wants to maybe think in a more abstract space. I want to not develop solutions, I wanted to work on problems where I don't even know if there's a solution at all. So I really felt I was drawn back into fundamental research. At the same time, when I did combustion research, I realized that in the Physical Chemistry Institute, because I had a background in theoretical physics, in fundamental laser spectroscopy, I came from basic research, I had different knowledge. And this knowledge helped me to develop new methods for laser spectroscopy in flames. So I realized it directly, it's not whether fundamental research or applied research is more important, we need both. Applied research is constantly taking the latest ideas from fundamental research. And then for me as a researcher, I know we have urgent problems in the world, but I also realized in our society people have to work on different aspects, and the best thing is if everybody does where he or she is best. So I decided to go back to fundamental research and work not on the problems of today, but provide the concepts and the fundamental knowledge for solving problems and providing new technologies in 20 or 30 years. So I went, actually it was a big step for me, I went from my native Germany to the United States. I will make a few remarks about the importance of international relationship in research in a moment. I went from the physics and chemistry of hot flames to the coldest matter ever done in research, and I went from applied research to basic research. And this took me to Cambridge, Massachusetts, and to the Massachusetts Institute of Technology. So I was just saying, I experienced myself the tension, should I work on applied research or fundamental research? In the end, every person has to be at the right place, but it is also important to be close to both. And MIT is famous it's the best engineering school, or top rated as the best engineering school in the world now for many, many years in a row. On the other hand, we are top engineering school, but we are also rated as the best physics graduate school. So this shows that we have two strong pillars. We train students, we educate students in the basic scientists, people who work on fundamental knowledge, and at the same time, we have the strongest engineering department, and we have students who file for patents and immediately have startup companies when they leave MIT. So I think to have, especially in a university, basic and applied research together is important for a number of reasons. One is you want to attract students who are interested in doing this or that or trying to figure it out. And if you give students a broader choices, you will attract them and then they can sort things out. Also, the interplay of basic aspects of science and applied science is, of course, a knowledge pool. People can work in an interdisciplinary area, they can ask each other for advice, and quite often you have seen that something which came in fundamental research was important in applied research, or I, as somebody who needs the latest technology to do fundamental research, sometimes I get advice and help and maybe even have a collaboration with people in engineering. So that's what I wanted to say about applied and fundamental research. We need a reasonable combination of both, and to focus too selectively on one or the other is missing out on something. The second comment I want to make about international research. Being a German who went to the United States, I'm often asked by, especially in Germany, what should we learn from the United States? And my answer is always Germany and the US, and I should include Switzerland, definitely, are the best places to do research, both fundamental and applied. And secondly, we educate one of the best students. When Germans feel, is our university system inferior to the American one, I have to tell them some of my best students and postdocs, they were educated in Germany, they come to MIT and they are among the top researchers there. So I think we have in Germany and Switzerland a lot to be proud of, and it is not about copying something from another country like the United States. It is really being aware of your own strengths. Germany and Switzerland have a very special tradition in, let's say, engineering and how we educate students. And I know, as a student in Germany and at the Max Planck Institute, I learned things which I would not have learned in the United States. So it is really drawing from your own tradition, but being open to learn new things and then combining things. So for me, therefore, science has a local aspect. It is built on local traditions, but then, of course, we need international exchange, international collaboration, and international students. So given that, it was actually a unique moment for me when I was on a bicycle tour in Iceland, and here I am in the crack, in the fault between the two continental plates, the American continental plate and the European continental plate. So this is where the two continents come together. And I think here today in Schaffhausen, we are also in a place where literally bridges have been built to connect two cultures. So I think it's a great place for SIT and for the future of this university. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Wolfgang. We have time for a couple of questions. If anyone would like to ask a question. So let me ask one. In fact, it's good to be in the continental divide. But what do you think Europe should do to take advantage of this incredible tradition and scientific culture that it has, and to be more visible in the world?
I do feel Europe has really taken advantage of it. I'm terribly impressed what Europe has done with the European Research Council, the way how they have a now Europe-wide competition for grants. They give young researchers startup grants, and the young researcher can take these startup grants and settle in any European country they want and start their research group. So it has really increased competitiveness within Europe, and I think it has also increased the visibility of European research. I mean, I, I mean, I felt when I went to the United States, well, that's almost, you know, more than 25 years ago, there was a lot of features which attracted me to the United States. But Europe has not only caught up, I think in certain aspects, Europe is now a better place for research than the United States. There's really a very, very big difference in how Europe makes commitment to, you know, funding research and the US. In the US, the National Science Foundation is concerned that every year there can be a budget which slashes the budget of major agencies by 30%. Fortunately, the Congress did not act on this suggestion by our president, whereas in Germany, they have made a commitment that for so and so many years, every year, the budget for research will be increased by 5%. And that's what we need. In research, we have projects which take 5 or 10 years. We make commitments to graduate students. Our graduate students at MIT usually work for 6 years. And if there's an uncertainty every single year where the money comes from, this is really bad for research. So I think Europe is a very, very good ecosystem for research at this point.
Thank you very much again, Wolfgang. We look forward to hearing you again on more technical topics later in the day. Thank you.